Hey there, Steve Nixon here with FreeJazzLessons.com. Thanks for joining me here for today's video. All right, today I want to talk about three of my favorite albums. Now, when I say favorite, I'm not necessarily talking about kicking back, drinking a beer, and just sort of listening in the background. I'm talking about musician favorite, like albums that I've used to learn from and really dig into and that really influenced my playing, right? So the first album that I just absolutely love and I've learned so much from it is Barry Harris's album Live at the Jazz Workshop. All right, so check this out. When I left Berkeley, I was a pretty good player. I was playing professionally and I was gigging and I was playing jazz and I was a good player, right? But right around that time is right when I found that Barry Harris album. And what I discovered was, and I've pretty much transcribed every single Barry Harris solo on that album, was that my bebop knowledge wasn't really where I wanted it to be. And when I went through that album and I learned all the different concepts that Barry was doing in it, it completely changed my playing. I got so many different enclosure patterns and reharmonization techniques and rhythms and the way he was connecting chord changes. I just learned so much from that, right? So I highly recommend that you pick up a copy and start studying. Now, if you're a little bit busy and you're not a great transcriber, your ear isn't 100% there yet, I do have a product where I actually teach you a lot of the patterns that I learned, a lot of those bebop patterns in context of solos and how to build your own licks. It's called the Jazz Masters Method DVD, right? So I would recommend that. We also go through a lot of other players as well, people like Diana Krall and Herbie Hancock and Chick Corea and Oscar Peterson, right? But if your ears are good, you can definitely and should definitely pick up Barry Harris Live at the Jazz Workshop. Now, the next album that I totally recommend students pick up is Bill Evans Alone. And this is, just as the title says, Bill Evans playing solo piano. And I've learned so many chords and different ways of filling in sounds and reharmonizations from just sitting down and also transcribing all that Bill was doing on that album. And there's some transcriptions out there you can look at. A lot of them are inaccurate, to be completely frank. So the best thing you can absolutely do is just sort of grab a chart of what the tune is supposed to be, a basic sort of bare bones lead sheet, and listen to what Bill does with it. Use your ears and transcribe it. Figure out all those different moves. Highly, highly recommend it. And I've spent, years of my life sitting down and exploring that album. There's just so much good stuff in there. Now, if you want to see how I use those particular chords that I've discovered and putting them in context of a lot more tunes, we have a ton of training inside the Premium Jazz Membership Program where I actually teach you a lot of those chords and simplify them in more of a step-by-step way, in a jazz education way. So you can check out that product, but also highly recommend that you pick up a copy of Bill Evans Alone. Now, the third album that I recommend students get is Miles Davis's Kind of Blue. And this album completely changed my life. I'm saying album, it's kind of an old-fashioned term, CD, MP3, whatever you want, right? However you prefer to listen to this great music. It's completely changed my life. I was listening to a lot of rock and reggae and different styles of music. And it was a natural evolution for me once I first heard it, because a lot of the tunes in there, harmonically speaking, are pretty simple. Not the music. The music is really deep. But from a chord changes perspective, it's pretty simple. You have tunes like So What on there, which is just two chords, D minor and E flat minor the whole time. So I learned a ton of stuff about phrasing, about how to use simplicity in your soloing, rhythm, how to play modally, right? Bill Evans, from my last example, is actually the piano player through a certain part of that album as well. He was the piano player on So What, so I learned all kinds of cool chords and things like that, right? So it's a really rich album, and once again, I highly recommend that not only do you listen, but you actively listen. Sit down and loop it a lot of times. Figure out those chord changes. Get your ears involved. It's really all about learning from these great masters, right? Now, if, again, using your ears a little bit tougher. You don't have 20 hours a day to practice like I did when I was going into this. I do teach a lot of the rhythm concepts and a lot of the licks and the different ways that I learned that Miles Davis was using, for example, on So What. Inside the Premium Jazz Membership Program is actually our improv drills number 1, 2, and 3 inside that program. And I'll show you how to get that stuff in a step-by-step method. All right, so that is 3 albums. If you go really deep into those, they will change your life for sure. And they're just great to listen to and great to learn from. All right, thanks for watching. Happy practicing, and I'll see you at freejazzlessons.com. Thanks.